Talkback is brought to you by
Fizzy Soda, the ultimate refreshment. Get fizzy with it.
One thing about Missy Elliott videos, beyond the abstract and the absurdism which was common in her videos and videos of people like Ludacris and stuff, is that Missy always had really tight choreography.
Everything you expect from a Missy track was in there. Crazy dance moves, the makeup changes, don't even get me started on the glitter lipstick, and of course the Pharrell puppets, and it's just such an awesome tune.
It's a really nice video and I love it. I like the colors in it and I love the movements, the choreography and that.
And I appreciate that so much because nowadays people, beyond the Chris Browns, I mean, Missy's is, it tells a story and it complements, it adds to, it doesn't distract from the music, it adds to the music, and that's the thing I appreciate about her the most. So, I don't know if they're watching this, but Iggy, Nikki, y'all better be taking notes. Take a seat and take notes.
The almighty yellow star, God. Lyrically, I'm Optimus Prime. The car I ride, look for a ride. When I go by, smoke in your eyes. So open your eyes, the joke's on you guys. And you ain't gotta be a mason to see through some of this shit on occasion. What?
The dance that you're doing is dumb. How they do where you from?
Hey.
Sticking out your tongue, girl. But you know you're too young. A bunch of girls do it and the shit look fun. That's how they do where we from. You know it don't start till one. That's how they do it where they from. I'm like, make a new track, make them fall on they crack. Give them a slap appetizer and stack up so fat in the back, make the boys all collapse. Yeah, when I rap, they be all on my jack. Boys wanna tap on this prusy cat. Got a new idea, let me switch it. Man, I'm so futuristic. Big lips and big hips. Body be thick like a bitch with them different ripping shit. Microphone gripping it. Getting these Benjamins, new car whipping it. I'm so far ahead of y'all. Man, I'm on top of the stars. I don't care none of your all. Blah, 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 blah. You best to go rewrite your balls. How they do it where you from?
Hey.
How they do it where you from? That's how they do it where we from. That's how they do it where they from.
Shut it, what?
How they do it where you from?
Hey.
How they do it where you from? That's how they do it where we from. That's how they do it where they from.
Yo, 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 you are tuned in to Talk Back, proudly sponsored by The Drink in My Hand. That's the ultimate refreshment. Now, today we've got two topics in our hands. So, first of all, we're going to talk about the good and the bad, specifically good girls versus bad girls. We all know the good girls, that's the Taylor Swifts of the world versus the Miley Cyruses. So, we're going to go around Kampala, talk to different guys, see what they prefer and why they prefer, okay? So keep it right here. Don't go anywhere. Enjoy your breakfast. You might want to wash that down with some refreshing fizzy right here. Go outside, get yourself some, and keep it right there. You're tuned in to Urban TV. It starts here. Everybody seems to have their opinion about what's a good girl and what's a bad girl. So right now, I'm with some gentlemen right here.
What's your name? My name is Michael.
Mike.
Yeah.
And you're?
I'm OJ.
OJ. Is your last name by any chance Simpson?
No, just OG.
Good to know. So, Mr. Man, let's start with Mike right here. Mike, what's your opinion of a good girl versus a bad girl?
Good girl versus bad girl.
What would you define who's a good girl and who's a bad girl?
I think to me, a bad girl is this partying girl, party animal. Every day out, drinks a lot maybe, and always crazy, something like that. Doesn't go to church, of course. She's not a church girl. She's not a pastor's daughter.
Are you married or not?
I'm married.
You actually are married?
Married.
Wow.
Yeah.
Happily?
Really happily.
That's amazing.
Because I've not had any experience with a bad girl. Because I just met a girl, dated her, made her my wife. So I've not had an experience of a bad girl.
You know, okay, OJ, let's be honest right now. Let's be honest. Before you marry a girl, you have to actually have accepted the fact that she's a good girl. Everybody in the world, you tell them, man, I don't care what you think. It's my lady right here. Okay, let's talk about the days before you were married. Did you ever, you know, like the ladies that you dated, right? I mean, who would you prefer to go out with?
Definitely, of course, I would prefer to have a good girl. Because I believe a bad girl is one who will not wish to have me alone as a boyfriend.
Truly?
Yeah, she's like, okay, for now, it's you. But later, she's free, allow me be with anyone.
When she's with you, she's with you. When she's not with you, she's with somebody else.
So I think that's a bad girl. Then also, she's the one who boozes beyond I can do.
Yeah. The one who carries you home. OJ, get up.
Yeah, she has taken more and she's done taking me home.
Yeah. Like, dude, let me drive it.
Yeah.
Loki, tell me, who would you prefer to go out with? Like on a date, like who would you date? A good girl or a bad chick?
You see, it's a little bit ambiguous. When you're going out with a good girl, sometimes she gets that boring, you know? She doesn't put you in that crazy mood. You know, sometimes when you want to go out, like you're going to the beach or something, you need this crazy lady. You see, this crazy lady that turns you up when she drinks a little bit of it and she's all crazy, she's yapping. She's going wild. Sometimes when you're going out, you need a wild atmosphere. And now when you go with a good girl, she's that. Pastor's daughter.
And she probably brought a book to read it.
Sure. She's brought a Jane Eyre. Brought a Jane Eyre. Oh, this one, Pride and Prejudice. Mm-hmm. The bad girl who is a little bit romantic will bring a Pride and Prejudice. Now there's a bad girl. If you get this bad girl politically motivated, you'll find her with Ngugi wa Thiong'o. You know that's a wrong button to touch.
And also, of course, a bad girl is that who does not want you to introduce her as your girlfriend.
Okay,
she just wants to be a friend.
So, okay, wait a minute. When you go out with a bad girl to a party or something, she doesn't want you to introduce her as a girlfriend.
Not a girlfriend, you know, but just a friend.
So she wants to keep her options open.
Yeah, she should be available for someone else to say, hey, what's up?
Okay, what up? Because she's out there for the bigger, better deal, right?
Exactly. Mm. Yeah, so I would really prefer have a good girl.
And also, on the good girl part of it, it's good, like, first of all, if she has esteem, you know, you can feel respected. Of course, when you're going to church, and you're going with this good girl, sure, you have it all. Why are the ladies always? The left-hand side? Is it left when you're moving? Are you a gentleman?
I think the right ones, you put them on the
right. Are you a gentleman?
Me, myself. I'd let you to be the judge. I don't know.
I'd like to think so, though. Yeah.
Because when you walk with this lady who brings attraction, like not as in attraction, but some guys to get jealous. The guy's got this elegant and the elegant lady. You know, there's a difference between elegance and beauty. Elegance comes from behavior, the way of dressing, and those small, small things that most often some people don't value.
Yeah.
And I think the good girl has got to be that elegant to me.
Guys, keep it right here. We're still talking about the good and the bad in this society. We're proudly sponsored by Fizzy, the ultimate refreshment. Keep it right here. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back.
Talkback is brought to you by
Fizzy Soda, the ultimate refreshment. Get fizzy with that.